Hi guys! Today I'm going to show you how to make this Monchi squishy phone case inspired by the movie The Mitchells vs. the Machines.
That's not a feral hog, it's Monchi!
For this DIY, you'll be needing memory foam. The first thing you want to do is draw a rough outline using permanent marker. I'm drawing out the shape of a snowman. Then you want to cut around that shape. Have an adult help you with this part. Next, I'm going to cut along the middle to separate the head and the body. Now I'm going to round off the edges. To do this, you want to cut diagonally along the edges and cut several small snips to smooth it out. Don't forget to also round off the bottom portion, which is going to be the body. Now that I have my basic shape, I'm going to smooth this out even more so that it looks nice and round. This is how your squishy should look after you smooth it out. Next, I'm going to be cutting out the muzzle. I drew out the shape I wanted and then cut along the outline, and I also rounded the top of the sponge. Next, I cut out four oval shapes for the arms and legs. I also cut out the ears and the tail. I'm going to be gluing these down with puffy paint, which is a paint that dries flexible. Other paints, such as acrylic paint, will dry hard, so if you squish it, it will crack. If you have a problem with the legs sticking out like this, you can use a piece of tape to hold it down while it dries. I'm going to finish gluing down all my pieces. Before you move on to painting, you want to make sure these pieces are completely dry. Now I'm going to start painting Monchi. For this beige color, I mixed a lot of white puffy paint and a little bit of brown and yellow paint. If you want to cover up the holes of the sponge completely, you'll have to do about 3 layers of this. I forgot to add the tail earlier, so I'm adding that in right now. For my third layer of paint, I decided to shade the squishy with a golden brown color. And to make this color, you mix white, brown, yellow, and orange. Don't forget to also paint the backside. Although you won't see the backside of the squishy, it's still important to paint it because it's going to make the squishy more slow rising. I'm painting the muzzle a dark brown color. I started off with a big paintbrush and then moved on to a smaller paintbrush as I got close to the edges. Next, I'm going to be drawing the mouth and painting the ears. Toothpicks are very useful for painting small areas and details. Now I'm drawing the snout and whiskers. Then I'm using white puffy paint to draw two circles for the eyes. Then you want to draw a brown ring around the eye. And the final details for the eyes are two black dots. Another detail I'm adding are the claws. And finally, I'm drawing the tongue with pink puffy paint. This is the finished Monchi squishy. It's very big and slow rising. As long as you painted at least 3 to 4 layers of paint, your squishy should be really slow rising. Now let's glue the squishy onto a phone case. I'm using a clear case and gluing it down with hot glue. Feel free to be creative with the phone case. You can either paint your own or buy a colored phone case. I only used a little bit of hot glue for this video, but you definitely want to use a lot more hot glue if you want your squishy to not fall off. So now that the squishy phone case is finished, let's see how it looks with the phone. This is how it looks like on the back of my phone. The squishy is really big and fun to squish. I hope you try this DIY out, and don't forget, The Mitchells vs. the Machines is now streaming on Netflix. Bye!